welcome to our 69th annual sex panel in honor of our sex issue of this week. Today I have with me four consenting Brunswickan staff members who are willing to answer some questions about sex. And I guess to begin, could you all introduce yourselves?
My name's Alexander the Great.
He wishes. I'm Stephanie.
I'm Adam.
And I'm Jadrian.
All right, and I'm Emma. I thought to start off, seeing as earlier this year, Justin Trudeau revealed his porn star name. It was Smokey Sussex, I believe. Could you guys let us know what your porn star name is?
Ooh, it's been a while.
Is it not Alexander the Great?
It's...
Oh.
That's my personal use name. My professional name was, I don't know, Candy? I think it was actually my Candy. It's very generic.
I could get paid for that.
The Italian Stallion.
Oh. I just generally go with the usual nickname that I have, which is just Jade, because apparently everyone says it's a stripper name.
Alrighty.
When I actually first met you, you said, "Hi, I'm Jade." I was like, "Oh, you're a stripper."
Yeah.
Oh, we have a stripper.
Oh, yeah.
You know. Biggest turn on.
Wheels are spinning on corn.
Wheels are spinning. Look, like, I'm in this corner line here, but I think being on the spot is my biggest turn on.
probably being bitten on the neck.
Yeah. So you're into like Edward Cullen?
Old vampire stuff.
My biggest turn on is consent. Play safe, kids, and always ensure you have a consenting person.
Is this an ad?
I would have to say that my biggest turn on is aquatic mammal sex.
Moving on to the next question. What's your favorite or most interesting place to have sex?
It was on a hill, and then it was like rolling down the hill. So it was all along the hill. It was great.
Was that planned, or did you just fall?
It was a little bit of both.
I would say that the most interesting place so far has been the new truck. Never had
new truck
vehicle sex before.
Some of that new truck smell, really just...
good suspension?
Ooh, got the new stank already in it.
I like to reconnect with nature. Jade?
I enjoy camping in the summer, and all I'm gonna say is that the woods are... you're all by yourself. Have you ever heard of the shaking tent?
Maybe what your reaction was.
Oh, no.
I don't think I ever got the talk. I think they just assumed that I was never going to have any sex, so they figured that was probably not an issue.
When I was 10 years old, my mom took a wine glass and a beer bottle and attempted to demonstrate at the kitchen table, and I was like, "Mom, don't. I already found Dad's porn video. Just stop."
Oh, no.
Wait, do you mean your dad was starring in the video?
No!
That, you should really elaborate on that, because I was like, that's
so
really
your dad's porn video.
It was my dad's porn video.
It was his one video. This was kind of before like the internet was really popular.
No, it wasn't homemade. Like, it was in the VCR, and I was trying... I think I was trying to watch Sailor Moon, and I was like, why isn't this working? Click. That's not Sailor Moon.
I never really got it from my parents, but I talked to the kids who like sat in the back of the bus a lot, so I had a street education.
Oh, yeah.
It probably wasn't the best, to be honest.
I don't think I ever got the talk from my parents either. I did get the school version of, as they say, Mean Girls, "If you have sex, you will die." And the version from the older kids on the playground who thought that it was very important to give us all the wrong details of sex.
Yeah. And for a final question, best pickup line. Also, did it work?
Someone else start? I'm really bad with these.
Okay, well, the pickup line used on my partner was, he's a paramedic student, so I was like, "Hey, can you show me how this tourniquet works?" Got him in real close, got a kiss.
It's actually a personal hobby of mine, but one of my favorites is, "Are you from Mactaquack? Because damn." In terms of pickup lines used on me, my girlfriend told me I had a nice beard, and here we are almost 1 year, so there you go.
Better than ever beard.
On I'm just trying to think, but I think anything that makes fun of the classics, like, hey, did it hurt when you fell from heaven? Because that's fuck.
Okay, here's one that worked on me one time. So this girl walked up to me, and I thought she was really attractive, and she came to me and she said, "You'll do." Just.
Oh.
Just got me right there.
That's all Alex really needs.
And on that note, thank you for watching the 69th annual sex panel. Hope you learned some tips that you can use this Valentine's Day.